Good afternoon, Matt Doran with this special 10 News bulletin. In breaking news, Prime Minister Julia Gillard has bowed to pressure from her party and called a caucus meeting for 4:30pm Eastern Time for a leadership ballot. Now, in breaking news, further breaking news, in just the last few minutes, Kevin Rudd has spoken on his way into that caucus meeting and has sensationally said he will not be contesting the leadership. Take a listen to what he had to say.
I've been very plain about that for a long period of time. Secondly, I've also said that the only circumstances under which I would consider a return to the leadership would be if there was an overwhelming majority of the parliamentary party requesting such a return, drafting me to return, and the position was vacant. I'm here to inform you that those circumstances do not exist. And therefore, in the absence of any such draft, notwithstanding what Simon Crean had to say this morning, I will be adhering absolutely to the commitment that I gave to the Australian people and to my parliamentary colleagues. This is a difficult day for the Australian Labor Party, it's a difficult day for the Australian government, but I take my word seriously. I've given that word, I gave it solemnly in that room after the last ballot, and I will adhere to that word today.
All right, let's go now straight to TEN's political editor, Hugh Rimmington in Canberra. Hugh, what are we to make of this? Is this a strategic play, perhaps, by Kevin Rudd? He seems very, very hell-bent on honouring his pledge not to challenge again Julia Gillard.
If there's some overarching tactic at work here, it utterly defeats me to try to interpret it. This is a shambolic mess that we have seen today. Under intense pressure as a week that has gone on, Simon Crean, a long-time Gillard loyalist, a spear carrier for her in the past, went into her office this morning, had a conversation with her, indicated that he was going to shift support away from the Prime Minister. She asked him to go away, think about it. He did go away. He came back in the afternoon. He said to a point blank, you need to call a leadership ballot today. And if you don't, I will go out there and encourage MPs to take an action which is available to them to get a petition together so that a special caucus meeting could be held so that a leadership vote could be taken. He says that the Prime Minister said, well, I'm not calling a leadership ballot. What she did do was sack Simon Crean from the front bench. She then walked into Parliament and announced that she would call a leadership spill. Caucus is gathering right now in the meeting to have this leadership spill. As they walked in, as you just heard, Kevin Rudd said, you know what? I'm not part of this. I'm not going to be putting myself up for this. I said I wouldn't launch a challenge. I would only conceive of being returned to the leadership if there was overwhelming support and if the position was vacant. He will keep his word. He is not standing. Simon Crean is still apparently going to stand for the deputy position, challenging Wayne Swan for that position. But Simon Crean plainly intended and believed that Kevin Rudd would stand. He said he would support Kevin Rudd. He said he wasn't part of a ticket, but he believed Kevin Rudd had the numbers. Kevin Rudd isn't even going to test the numbers. It would now seem bizarre in the extreme if anything was to happen other than have Julia Gillard re-emerge from this caucus meeting as leader. Mind you, the way we're going at the moment, almost anything could happen, Matt.
Quite remarkable, as you say, Hugh. It is something very suspicious has happened between that moment when Simon Crean came out in the morning and said the Prime Minister enjoyed his support, and then a matter of hours later, something had gone wrong. He declared that there was a cause there for a spill, and he's come out and had this to say at a press conference at about 1 o'clock this afternoon.
You've seen the frustration I've been expressing in recent times. It seems to me the party, through the government, is in a stalemate position. Something needs to be done to break this deadlock, to resolve the issue once and for all, and to enable us to get on with the job that we're actually elected to do, and that is to campaign on behalf of Australian people through Labor values. I have talked to the Prime Minister yesterday and today, and as a result of that conversation, I informed her that I would think about my position and get back to her before I made this announcement. But I am asking her to call a spill of all leadership positions in the party. I will not be standing for the leader. I will be putting myself forward in the leadership team for the deputy leader. If the Prime Minister does not agree to it, which I expect she won't, then I urge members of caucus to petition in the appropriate way for the calling of such a meeting. This is an issue that has to be resolved. There's too much at stake. This is a very regretful decision for me. I think everyone knows the relationship between the Prime Minister and myself goes back some time. This is not personal. This is about the party, its future, and the future of the country.
So, Hugh, just what has gone on here? Are we to believe that this is, I guess, a choreographed effort on behalf of the Crean-Rudd team, if you like? One MP has reportedly described Crean as a wholly owned subsidiary of Rudd Enterprises, and that was just recently. And yet Crean insists that he has had no discussions with the Rudd camp over the last 48 hours. What has gone on here?
Well, if this was a choreographed arrangement, it's the worst piece of dance you'll ever see in your life. Simon Crean, as you say, admitted he hasn't spoken to Kevin Rudd for 48 hours at least. So he apparently was working on the assumption that Kevin Rudd would get up and stand, and Kevin Rudd has left Simon Crean hanging in the wind and looking like an utter goose at the moment. Julia Gillard, the Prime Minister, has just walked into the caucus meeting surrounded by a phalanx of other senior ministers, those standing in support of her. Anthony Albanese, who voted for Kevin Rudd in the last challenge in February of last year, says can be no question Julia Gillard will emerge from this meeting as the Prime Minister. And furthermore, Anthony Albanese says he will be voting for Wayne Swan as the deputy. So Simon Crean appears to be getting absolutely nothing out of this. This was an utter schmozzle. I could imagine there are theories and assumptions going that perhaps this was some devious, clever play by Simon Crean to, I don't know, force it to a vote knowing that Kevin Rudd wouldn't get up. But if that was the case, it also caught Kevin Rudd supporters by surprise, because ever since the Prime Minister walked out of Parliament at the end of question time, 20 or more MPs went into Kevin Rudd's office. These are his supporters, urging him to stand in this leadership ballot. We know the result. He has walked out, disappointed his supporters, and said he will not stand. This is a leadership challenge with no challenger, Matt.
The long, hard walk. The Prime Minister heading into Parliament, knowing her government's media reforms had collapsed and her key supporters had abandoned her.
The party needs to get its act together. That's the truth. The stalemate has to end.
Party elder and long-time Gillard supporter Simon Crean spoke to her this morning. He met her again a few hours later and formally asked her to step aside.
But I am asking her to call a spill of all leadership positions.
She told him she would not. But as question time opened, with Labour MPs circulating petitions to cut her down, she bowed to the inevitable.
I have determined that there will be a ballot for the leadership and deputy leadership of the Labour Party at 4:30 today. In the meantime, take your best shot.
Then followed a surreal session. While Kevin Rudd busily wrote notes, the Prime Minister fought on as if nothing was up.
The government will continue to pursue the agenda that we've set for ourselves and the Australian nation.
But she was taunted every inch of the way.
For our country's good, you should go. You should go.
The opposition tried to bring her down immediately with a vote of no confidence.
Madam Speaker, I seek leave to move that this House has no confidence in the Prime Minister.
That failed, but glancing ahead to the likely leadership change, the opposition shifted its attack from the Prime Minister personally to her divided party.
It is deep, it is personal, it is vicious, and it will not go away.
A House divided against itself cannot stand.
Politicians often say opinion polls don't matter, but the challenge today was expressly as a result of them.
We can't win from the position we're in the polls. I'm doing this in the interests of the Labor Party and, in turn, the nation.
Julia Gillard thought otherwise. She immediately sacked him from her front bench, but he'd got what he wanted, a vote. Thank you.
All right, Hugh, what do we make of the timing of all this? The speculation has been ongoing, has been intensifying now for weeks, and yet it seems that the opposition, well, they were taken by surprise by this today.
Well, I mean, what's happened there is that Simon Crean got his vote, but he didn't have a challenger. Totally bizarre. This is amateur hour politics. The opposition plainly was assuming, as professional politicians, that if Simon Crean had shifted his votes apparently behind Kevin Rudd, urging Kevin Rudd to run, and saying that he believed Kevin Rudd would have the numbers, the opposition was assuming, like many others, that he probably did have the numbers. And so you could see them in Question Time starting to shift the attack, laying a few blows on the Prime Minister, but also turning and attacking the person they thought was going to win that vote, Kevin Rudd. Just an hour ago, no one in that chamber, except possibly Kevin Rudd himself, had any inkling that he wouldn't be standing in this leadership vote. That is how it's panning out now, Matt.
All right, thanks very much to Hugh Rimmington outside Parliament House there for us. We'll cross back to Hugh a little bit later. But let's go now to TEN's National Affairs editor, Paul Bongiorno, who's in Canberra for us. Paul, what are you hearing about the numbers here? Obviously, Labor caucus has come together. They are voting as we speak. What are we hearing about the numbers?
Well, we're hearing about the numbers that there will be no contestant, there'll be no contender for the leadership of the Labor Party. Therefore, Julia Gillard will be re-elected unopposed. It'll be interesting to see now if Simon Crean puts his hand up for the deputy leader's position. The supposed Rudd ticket was Rudd Albanese, but Anthony Albanese, on his way into the caucus, stopped and told the media that he would not be putting his hand up to run against Wayne Swan, the current deputy leader of the Labor Party. So it'll be interesting to see whether Simon Crean goes ahead with his challenge to Wayne Swan. There is an element to what's happened today. Last year, the Gillard forces, and at that stage Crean was one of them, goaded Kevin Rudd to run against Julia Gillard, and Crean went on radio and he said Kevin Rudd shouldn't squib it this time. He squibbed it before. He shouldn't squib it this time. Well, of course, he ran and he got defeated very heavily. This time, Kevin Rudd has, if you like, an excuse. And his excuse is that he said to the Australian people he would not challenge, that he would only be leader again if it was the overwhelming view of the Labor caucus. And clearly today it is not the overwhelming view. And he's read that right. By the way, there's a bit of precedent for this in the way John Howard finally came back to the leadership. He spent about 2.5 months behind closed doors trying to convince, you might remember, Alexander Downer to go quietly. In the end, he promised him if they win the election, as they were set to do, he could be foreign minister, and that suited Alexander just fine, and there was no blood on the floor, and the rest is history, our second longest serving prime minister. I think Kevin Rudd realises that in an election year, you can't take it by a bloody coup. You have to take it by the will of the party, including the incumbent. And there's no way that Julia Gillard is going to put her head on a plate for Kevin.
Bond, you're right. There certainly is the historical precedent there. The second Fraser challenge, as we know, succeeded. The same with Keating against Hawke. Some are predicting perhaps the same today. But if this does put to bed the issue, the speculation surrounding Kevin Rudd, how then does Julia Gillard still move forward? This government is in turmoil. As you would imagine, it is very, very difficult to govern when you have, you're looking in the face of these comments from someone as senior as Simon Crean, whose family is virtually royalty within the Labor Party.
Well, Simon Crean may well argue that what he did today, and in fact he said that he's at his doorstep, that he was doing this to stop the white noise, that this was destroying the party, something had to give. I suspect that his doorstop today was aimed very much at putting, as I said earlier, pressure on Kevin Rudd. Now, the only hope Labor's got, and I've got to tell you, it's a very thin hope, because while Gillard and Rudd remain in the parliament, they're a bit like Howard and Peacock in the 80s. The other one always looks better on the back bench, so you go to them and so on and so forth, and all you're doing is favouring your opponents. So coming back to that, I think that that Crean, if this resolves the issue and the people who have been talking to the media have been destabilising the party get the message, that will give Labor some hope of regrouping. And as I say, as of today, it looks like a divided party with not much hope of coming together.
To say the very, very least. All right, very much thank you to Paul Bongiorno for us in Canberra.